You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
CBS News reports U.S. soldiers returning from Liberia are held for at least 21 days in Italy on a U.S. military base before they are allowed to come back into the United States. But then meanwhile, the CDC, the Centers for Spreading Disease, has rebuked the governor of New Jersey, Chris Christie, saying you need to release the nurse that you believe came in contact with Ebola and who might have it. You need to send her home. I guess like this other doctor that tested positive with Ebola last week and is now going into the more serious bleeding stages of it, the Associated Press is reporting, he needed his freedom as well to go to a restaurant, a bowling alley, ride the most busy A-train, subway, and take taxicabs. So now Governor Cuomo and Governor Christie of New York and New Jersey are both saying that, okay, if somebody's been treating an Ebola patient and they get a fever and look sick, we're just going to let them basically do whatever they want. The default with somebody that has drug immune or drug resistant TB, and there is drug immune, they don't call it that, they don't want to scare the public, but there's TB out there that you can't cure. They lock you up, basically for the rest of your life, because it will spread and then hundreds of thousands could die. Back when they couldn't treat TB, millions and millions died a year in the U.S. alone. You know how many famous people, when you read history books, even up in the 1930s and 40s, died? They had things called sanitariums that weren't mental institutions. They were like these big convalescence places just full of people that had it. And it wouldn't matter, you know, even if you could get up and walk around and you could go out and play croquet, or a lot of them had swimming pools. It was just kind of like a leopard colony. That's where you lived. And the nurses and doctors that worked there, in most cases, they had it as well. So you form your own communities not to spread it. Well, the new progressive thing to do is to share it. Don't quarantine people that had HIV early on. Let it go from just a few dozen to millions that have it. Don't quarantine people that have Ebola in the tens of thousands. Let millions get it. Absolutely. Everybody else is shutting their borders and blocking the flights for 2.5 months now, almost 2.5 months. Christie says nurse quarantined for Ebola can go home after he was rebuked by the White House. NBC News is reporting right now. So White House presses states to reverse mandatory Ebola quarantine orders. Obama demands states stop following proper protocol. New York Times. Coming up today, Steve Quayle is scheduled to be with us, and then Joel Gilbert for a full hour interview. I tend to not put out talking points like I should so we can all kind of get a grasp, at least on where I'm coming from. But it's so crystal clear the last few weeks that I should have been beating a drum here, because that drum is the truth. And it's that they're trying to cover up what's really going on with Ebola until the election is over in what? Not that long, like a week from now. So they are covering up what's really going on with Ebola and trying to say there's nothing happening. And they have this spin doctor up there as the czar, who has no medical background, to snow job everybody. So we won't find out what's really happening with the Ebola until after the election. But all the signs show there's a huge cover-up going on. We're being lied to. We have a special intro coming up that Jakari Jackson put together. Stay with us. We're live on this Monday. The experts are clear. Sunlight, purified water, healthy non-GMO food, and having a good attitude is essential to a healthy immune system. But I go further with Super Nascent Iodine X2 from InfoWarsLife.com. 50% stronger than our original and revolutionary Nascent Iodine formula, coming from a deep earth crystal source that no other supplier has. Most other forms of iodine come from seaweed in areas plagued by Fukushima and other contaminants. Not our iodine. It comes from over 200 million year old crystal salt deposits and is tested and proven to be completely pure. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today. See the informational videos. Read the information there compiled. And for a limited time, when you use promo code NOW at checkout, you get an additional 5% off the entire family of InfoWarsLife.com products. Secure your Survival Shield X2 today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll free 888-253-3139.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. Put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it, others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans, made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it, others don't.
Using unparalleled research in the development of a synergistic formulation based around the key concepts of super oxygenation, the next level in cleansing is here. With key ingredients backed by real clinical studies, the new Oxy Powder, available through InfoWars Life, was invented during Dr. Group's research on the toxification of our bodies. Many herbal colon cleansers are harsh on the body and contain cheap and potentially dangerous ingredients, oftentimes full of synthetic fillers, GMOs, additives, or worse. Gently start cleaning your body with easy capsules that start working while you sleep. Oxy Powder does not require time off work, and there's no need for bad-tasting concoctions. Instead, Oxy Powder slowly releases monoatomic oxygen into the intestinal tract and body. Experience the astonishing cleansing power of superoxide and ozonide technology. Go to InfoWarsLife.com or InfoWarsStore.com to get started with Oxy Powder, or call 1-888-253-3139.
We now take you live to the Central Texas Command Center in the heart of the resistance. It's Alex Jones.
We're live, ladies and gentlemen. It is the 27th day of October, 2014. It is extremely crystal clear now, studying the global Ebola crisis, that Western governments in Europe, in England, and other areas are trying to block the Ebola coming in. And the United States, the people running it, are doing everything they can to A, bring it in, and B, cover up that it's spreading. Steve Quayle joins us in the second hour today to give us his take and from his sources where he thinks all this is going. Love him or hate him, he wrote books back in the mid-1990s predicting airborne Ebola would be the false flag here in the United States. I'm looking forward to hearing what he has to say. Now, that said, there are two articles up on InfoWars.com and prisonplanet.com. They're also front and center, not hard to find on drudgereport.com because it's the top stories there. CDC rebukes Christie, the nurse who was treating Ebola patient who was quarantined, basically ordered release by the feds when the feds don't even have that power, states have quarantine power as well. So if we go to Drudge, we can show folks the front page there. CDC rebukes Christie, nurse released. Now, linked in red, right down below that, U.S. soldiers returning from Liberia are being placed in isolation in Vicenza, Italy. For more than 21 days, CBS News reports, even though they say that they're not showing any signs of having Ebola, that they will be held until they are found to be Ebola-free, and then they will be shipped back to whatever bases they came from, whether it be in Germany or the United States or somewhere else. Now, that is what you're supposed to do. When you come out of a hot zone as a medical worker or anybody else, you're supposed to be held in medical quarantine for 21 days. They have the Army bases for it. They have the hospital ships for it. The procedure for Doctors Without Borders, I went and looked it up, was sure enough to, depending on what you're treating and how long it incubates, you wait in the country. After you've been in the hot zone area in a hotel room or a house, so you can monitor yourself once you're out of the main hot zone on the edge of it, then you get on an airplane or on a boat and come back. And we know these people aren't self-quarantining. The doctor last week in New York that was coming back from Africa who had Ebola is now into the next stage of blood coming out of his orifices. AP is reporting he's now into that stage of his eyes turning red and all the rest of it. He went to the bowling alley and on the A train subway and to restaurants and to the store and now to the cabs, just all over the place. And he's a medical doctor. We appreciate him trying to fight Ebola, but why would he come back and be sick with a fever running around doing all this? Why would a nurse from Dallas who treated the Ebola patient out of fever call the CDC and say, can I fly? Oh, yes, honey, go ahead. So in those two articles, you see the dichotomy, the paradox. We should do an article just on this itself. One of our writers should, or somebody should, pointing out that the Army quarantines people that have been around Ebola, what you're supposed to do, and the Obama White House does everything it can to stop states from exercising their rights and their duty to quarantine people that have been around an Ebola patient and that have a fever. And people are like, Alex, don't push a police state. It's going to be a police state when this thing gets out of hand, which is very clear is going on right now. Because once this starts to spread, after the election, once they let us know it's spreading, if that is indeed the case, which it looks like it is, every signpost, every arrow, every alarm, every indicator points at that. I pray that's not the case. The public confidence believes it's spreading. The public is not confident in government. Those polls are out there. People know they're being lied to. So we've got this whole pantheon of issues going on. The military, the Army, is following its procedures and following the law and quarantining U.S. Army personnel. 5,000 were sent in. Now when some of them are set to go back out, or they're ill, they're being sent to a U.S. military base about a five-hour flight out of West Africa. And they land and they're quarantined. Not here in the U.S. You're a nurse treating an Ebola patient. You have a fever. Honey, you can go. That's why I marvel that the default position has been turned off and no reasons have been given. Now we have a five-year-old boy being tested for Ebola at New York City Hospital, at Bellevue Hospital, last night. And we're getting more reports from medical doctors who are scared and nurses that indeed people that show signs of Ebola bleeding out of every orifice are being disappeared by federal teams. We've had high-level Border Patrol break that down here as well. This is going on. Now, do they have Ebola? We don't know that, but why would they be disappearing them if it was malaria that only causes bleeding in very rare cases and doesn't look like Ebola? Why aren't they just putting a slide under the microscope and seeing that the parasite isn't there from malaria? Our story went mega viral around the web. We were avalanched. Crushed.